Good morning from Hilo. Today we woke up to this stunning white landscape. It's 6 a.m. now and the temperature is still sub-zero. You can see the frozen crystals around this pipe. It's 8:15. The weather has cleared. The sun is up now. It's really looking nice. Today we are going to trek to Bursar. This is the forest checkpost. To enter the sanctuary, we have to get a permit from this office. These are the rules one should keep in mind when trekking. So we have entered into the sanctuary. Bursar is mainly famous for its rhododendrons, red pandas, and the view of Kanchenjunga. As it's December, we are not supposed to get the flowers, but we are hoping to get a clear view of Kanchenjunga, as the weather is awesome and the pandim was seen clearly from Hile. Hile to Bursar is an easy trek. There are not many ups and downs in this 4-kilometer trail. You can find different species of birds here. We can already hear them chirping. If you are lucky enough, you can spot a red panda here. But they are naturally nocturnal and generally solitary animals. So I don't think I am that lucky. Can you see the sky? It's deep pastel blue, and see the moss hanging from the branches of the trees. I can hear the water flowing ahead. Let's see. You can spot these birds here, and we have actually spotted this one. On your way, you can dump your trash here. It says, I am here to keep Bursar clean. After 1.5 hours, we almost reached our destination. But the clouds are getting overpowered, and I don't think we will get a clear view. A bit of blue here. Let's see. And yes, the range is visible. Maybe you can see it as I'm shooting with my mobile. Wait, let me show you. So, here is the range. I think you can see it clearly now. the marvelous sleeping Buddha with all its glory. The prayer flags, waving in the wind. I just can't explain how beautiful this place is. This is Gorash Kunj, our stay for tonight. This is the Forest Barrack, another stay at Borse, established in 2002. This is the washroom of the barrack, though they also have attached baths. Now let's go and explore our Gorash Kunj. This is the camping ground of Gorash Kunj. A small setup, you can have your tea here. This is the common area of Gorash Kunj. Here is the kitchen. This is the double bedroom of the ground floor. From here, you can get a clear view of the mountains. Now let's go to the first floor. Wow. This is a dormitory. Our attendants said that 20 people can be easily accommodated in this room. Indeed, a huge room. You can get this view from here. All the blankets are stacked here. The dormitory is really good. Only one problem. The washroom is not attached. It feels good when you get a lunch like this in this sanctuary. Borse has no electricity. And you can't plan a bonfire in the forest. So chatting with your friends or enjoying nature are the only options in the long evenings. And so we did. It was a full moon night and the surroundings were washed by the ghostly moonlight. The sky was crystal clear. And the stars were shining like 1,000 glitters. The pure and solid white Kanchenjunga was standing proudly in the front of the dark blue background. The heavenly atmosphere was accompanied by the chilly wind, and though we were shivering, we decided to stay outside till 9, and then we had our dinner.
It's 5:45 now in the morning. You can see the moon is setting. We are here for the sunrise. It's freezing outside, and the last night's wind is still on. My hands are literally getting numb, but it's really worth it. See the changing colors of the range. We are going to the camping ground now. This is the barrack. These guys are camping here. They are from Gangtok. They reached here yesterday. This is our breakfast, luchi and aloo curry. All the credit goes to these guys. Time to say goodbye to Gurash Kunj. But we are going to visit again very soon for the rhododendrons. Thank you for watching. Stay safe and happy.